From the upper field of historic Doyle Field, we say a very good evening once again, everyone. Third game of a triple header of action today on Rivalry Family Media. Once again, a very good evening. Now up under the lights, last of three after two lacrosse matchups brings us to the baseball diamond. It's Leominster and Nashoba on a Saturday night. And great to have you along with us, Todd Robbins, alongside Bill Thomas and Kate Robbins, and happy to have you joining us wherever you are the world over, facebook.com/media rivalry. Games available on YouTube on delay as well. And great to have you joining us this evening. We're looking forward to this great battle of two storied baseball programs. For Nashoba, they come in with their first game of the season. They have yet to play a game in this 2021 season. They'll get their first one in tonight. Leominster comes in with a 1-0 overall record. A big win earlier this week, a 7-0 win over the Mountaineers of Wachusett is how they opened their season as well. So that's the backdrop that we have to look forward to with this action coming up this evening. Leominster and Nashoba got a great pitching matchup coming your way as well this evening. We're looking forward to previewing that one. Public address announcer, the legendary Dick Tucker, joins us this evening up here at Doyle Field as well. He's got a scholarship to present. We're going to pick up that scholarship introduction right now. Public address announcer, Dick Tucker. Well, stand by. We'll get Dick. Hang on a second.
I want to thank the Spartans real quick. If you attend football games, you'll hear me announcing ads. And I just want to mention those sponsors because without them, I wouldn't be able to do this. Dandini Disposal Services, Dandini Landscaping, Sherry and Doug Tamlin, Marigal Medical, Leominster Service Center, Played Against Sports, North Star Construction, Dragonfly Driving School, Dunkin' Donuts, Viola's Pittsburgh Tire and Service, Manny's Appliance, and Applebee's. And thanks to them and previous sponsors, we've given away over $12,000 to student athletes in the past 6 years. So this year, like last year, the awards are usually just before graduation, and they're going to be virtual again this year. And last year, all I did was mail the checks, which was rather impersonal. So I have a chance to do this in person to the male athlete. He's been on varsity baseball 2019 to the present. He was on the golf team in 2020, National Honor Society 2020 to present, camp counselor 2017 to present, Challenger League volunteer 29 to present, teacher and office assistant 2020, food pantry volunteer. He'll be attending Assumption College in the fall for baseball. His major will be major business and sports management. Our scholarship winner, male athlete, $500 is Evan McCarthy. Yeah. The starting lineups momentarily.
Dick Tucker representing the Blue Devil Football Club, the Blue Devil Athletic Club, and the Extended, able to put together that great scholarship program, recognizes one male, one female from Leominster High School Athletics. Eliza Howlett earlier today from the field hockey and lacrosse programs, and now Evan McCarthy from the baseball program and the golf program as we welcome in the third member of the team, Bill Thomas. And first, let's get Dick Tucker's introduction.
Yeah, I'm in no hurry. You hear me enough.
Shortstop Stephen Ritchie. Batting second, playing center field, number 10, Justin Klinkhammer. Batting third, catcher, number 7, Roland Bush. Next batter, third baseman, number 3, Connor Salmon. Designated hitter, number 14, Peter Ward. Second baseman, number 8, Peter Ocherholm. Pitching will be number 24, James Bossari. Third base, number 23, Josh Morrison. Right fielder, number 4, Patrick Arsenault. Head coach is Mr. Schoolcraft. Now your starting lineup for your Leominster Blue Devils. Leading off and catching, number two, Tyler Smith. Batting second to center fielder, number three, Sean Dutton. Designated hitter, number 23, Evan McCarthy. Batting fourth, third baseman, number eight, Nick Garcia. Batting fifth, first baseman, number 16, Brandon Arsenault. Batting sixth, second baseman, number 12, Tony Salvatelli. In left field, number 11, Nico Martinez. Right fielder is number six, batting eighth, Eamon Durkin. Shortstop, number nine, Nick Massa. On the mound for the Blue Devils will be number 10, Ryan Harris. This time, ladies and gentlemen, please face towards center field and our big, beautiful U.S. flag as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
And with that, pregame festivities here at historic Doyle Field are over. It's time now for baseball action. It's Leominster and Nashoba here on Rivalry Family Media. Time to set the lineups. Let's go right down this batting lineup for the Nashoba Chieftains. Stephen Ricci will bat leadoff. Justin Klinkhammer will bat in the two-hole. Nolan Bush will bat third. Connor Salmon will bat cleanup. The designated hitter, Peter Ward, will bat in the five-hole. Peter Olgerholm will bat sixth. James Basari, the pitcher, will hit for himself in the seventh spot. Josh Morrison will bat eighth. And Patrick Arsenault will bat in the nine spot. For Leominster, going left to right across the outfield, it's Nico Martinez, Sean Dutton, and Eamon Durkin. Left to right across the infield, going third to first, Nick Garcia, Nick Massa, Tony Sabatelli, and Brandon Arsenault. The battery for Leominster tonight, Tyler Smith does the catching. For Leominster's starting pitcher tonight, Ryan Harris, Bill Thomas. They get their first look tonight at Ryan Harris, Leominster, that big 7-0 victory over perennial power Wachusett the other night. A big way to start the season.
Harris is a big right-hander, too. We'll have to see if he, if his pitching speed and strength comes from his size or if he's a finesse curveball guy, but he's definitely got the size to bring it.
That part we will look forward to seeing as well. Kate, as you look at the early part of the season here, of course, baseball and softball not that far removed from each other. As we always say, when you look at the early part of the season, pitching tends to always be which? Ahead of hitting or a little bit behind?
Well, I mean, I was always a defensive specialist, so if you ask me, pitching is going to be the item du jour. And early in the season, you're going to want to have some healthy arms, and you're going to want to have a full battery, especially on the baseball side of things. So that's what Leominster's looking for. And Leominster traditionally has had, you know, a prolific ace that they've been able to go to on their squads, and that's usually brought them pretty deep into the playoffs. Something very different from softball. You need to have a full battery of pitchers in order to make things work. So we're going to see here how Leominster starts things off on defense from historic Doyle Field. So that'll be That'll be an interesting one. Waiting here, having last-minute conversations between the officials. You'll be able to see that on our second angle here. Both of the officials talking to the two head coaches in Coach Schoolcraft and Coach Barnaby here on the first base line. And right now, Leominster's defense kind of just waiting around. They're ready to go, but we're waiting on some administrative stuff.
I think the ground rules are pretty basic here at Doyle. The field is entirely encased in fencing. There's no out of bounds unless it gets through an opening in the fence. So pretty much everything's in play here. As long as it stays inside the fences, it makes for a much better game. You know, you're not having to award bases and things like that for most plays out of bounds, but everything's live here for the most part.
And as you point out, that deep triangle that's out in that left to right center field spot, we were walking that earlier. That's a solid poke out there of 400+.
I would put it at 425, maybe even a little bit more than that. But that's no man's land. You talk about a triangle similar to what you get at Fenway Park. That's exactly what we got here in right center field here at Doyle Field.
Facebook.com/media rivalry for this one tonight. And of course, as we say, you know, in some of our other broadcasts, we're looking to bring you the pictures and the play-by-play tonight. Bear with us here. It is through a remarkable sense of video that we've been able to give you the pictures. As we always say, we're an award-winning radio broadcast team, so it's a radio broadcast with pictures tonight. But we're looking forward to bringing you this one.
What you can't see, we'll describe.
We'll describe for you.
Well, we're going to try to let you see at least 50% of what we're seeing.
And no question about that.
But I tell you, I love this home plate look, Todd and Kate, and we'll have to see how this transitions into nighttime. And
first pitch of the ball game, called strike at 6:39 as we get underway at historic Doyle Field. And the first pitch from Harris is a called strike. Here comes Harris's 0-1. Goes with a sweeping breaking pitch that sails high and evens the count at 1-1.
Yeah, not much break on that breaking pitch right there, but mixing it up early. Two pitches, two different looks.
The 1-1 offering. Straight down the middle, lined at short, and just over the head of the shortstop, Nick Massa, into short left field. Martinez up with it and gets it in, and Ricci opens the ball game with a single.
Next up for the Wolves, the center fielder.
Looked like Nick might have misjudged that a little bit. I think he thought the ball was going to dip a little more at the last second. He realized it was well over his head, didn't quite get up there quick enough.
Public address announcer Dick Tucker calling Nashoba the Wolves. We can get into that action tonight. That is going to be their new mascot, but not officially implemented yet. Athletic director Tanya Rich says at this point in time, as Klinkhammer attempts the bunt on his second offering, it's bunted foul.
Not gonna lie, I'm kind of impressed manufacturing runs in the first inning in a baseball game.
I'm surprised they're giving up outs this early in the game, to be honest with you. But you got to remember, this is a 7-inning game, so you know, you got to get your runs while you can.
Nashoba going as the Nashoba baseball team, according to athletic director Tanya Rich, until they reach the conclusion of this season and can fully implement things. Here's the 0-1 to Klinkhammer. They go high and outside, see if Klinkhammer would offer at it. He will not, as they look to keep Richie close over at first. Just underway, Nashoba and Leominster, top of the first here on Rivalry Family Media, and great to have you along with us. Harris out of the stretch, leans in, high and inside on the 1-1. Count goes to 2-2.
Steady diet of fastballs up to this point. Seems to be his number one pitch. Mixed in a curveball, but fastball up, fastball in and out, I think what we're going to see mostly tonight.
Klinkhammer tries to get an idea of the count. The 2-1 from Harris onto the stretch. Goes high across the numbers and cut on and missed by Klinkhammer. Levels the count at 2-2.
Bringing the heat on that one.
Staring down, Harris shakes off the first, now the second. He's got the signal he wants. Richie staying close at first. The 2-2. Strike three.
Nice little curveball there. Pulled the string on him. Good location. Spotted that. Nice. Right at the knees.
Catcher number seven.
Harris gave up that initial signal, Bill Thomas, but then comes back with the K.
And he knew what he wanted to throw there. He shook off a couple of pitches. He got the curveball, and he put it right where he wanted it.
Nolan Bush comes to the plate. Check on Richie over at first.
If feel like I'm back in my element here. So 4 years doing the Dirt Dogs, 25, 26 games a season. I loved it. It's nothing like baseball.
Harris's first pitch, check swing, called strike on the pitch to Bush. Count goes to 0-1. Got the outside corner on that one. What have you seen early on here from Harris, Bill Thomas?
Well,
Harris comes with the 0-1 offering, popped up toward third base. Garcia will settle under it right along the line and make the catch for out number two.
Signal there's a foul ball there, foul ball catch. What I'm seeing is basically a two-pitch pitcher here. Harris, he's got a somewhat control of his curveball, but he's trying to spot that fastball, which I don't think he's found yet. But his curveball has really been working for him here these first couple of batters.
Two outs, Richie over on first. The cleanup hitter, Connor Salmon, will get a chance as they check on Richie over at first, back in time. Brandon Arsenault holding him close over at first base. Harris keeps sneaking a peek out of the stretch. The righty, a little worried about Richie here.
Could be a spot where they might put the runner in motion, two outs here. Try to get runner in scoring position here for your cleanup hitter.
Stares in. Here comes the first offering to Salmon. Down the middle, high pop fly towards center field. Drifting back under it is Dutton, who will settle in and make the catch in center field.
Room to spare out there.
One put into play in the inning, one stranded on. Otherwise, Leominster saw four come to the plate for Nashoba, retiring three. So no runs allowed there in the top of the first. Blue Devils coming up, and we'll set the lineup for you here. Leominster's starting lineup going straight down across the batting order. Tyler Smith, the catcher, will bat leadoff. Sean Dutton, the center fielder who made the catch to end the top of the first, will bat in the two-hole. Evan McCarthy, the designated hitter on his way to Assumption, bats third. Nick Garcia bats in the cleanup spot, the third baseman. Brandon Arsenault bats in the five hole. Tony Salvatelli, who had a big home run the other night against Wachusett, will bat sixth. Nico Martinez bats seventh. Eamon Durkin bats eighth. Nick Massa will round out the lineup, batting ninth. For the Nashoba baseball team, left to right across their outfield, it's Casey Arsenault, Justin Klinkhammer, and Patrick Arsenault come left to right across the infield, going third to first. Connor Salmon, Steven Ricci, Peter Olgerholm, Josh Morrison over at first base, and then there's the battery. Nolan Bush does the catching for James Borsari. Borsari had four starts, according to Coach Schoolcraft, as a freshman, and then Bill Thomas, 700 days between that time period.
But I bet you he's picked up a baseball between then and now. But that's a long time off, and we'll have to see what he's got here coming into the spring season. You know, this is the only season that has any sense of normalcy to it, to the athletes. You know, they started on time, so to speak.
Leading off for the Blue Devils.
And this is when baseball is supposed to be played, unlike the football and, you know, some of the basketball that we just went through.
I would agree with you, Bill Thomas. And so that brings Tyler Smith to the plate. Open the ball game for Leominster offensively. And he will face James Borsari. Borsari works out of the stretch, the right-hander. Got that foot staggered just a little bit toward first base. He'll step and first delivery. Ball called just off the corner.
Already shaking off his catcher on the first set of signals. Apparently they didn't talk about a sequence of pitches here.
Quick.
And the 1-0 misses as well.
Fast worker here with these first two throws. Leominster better be ready to swing when they get in that box.
That's alarming and disarming if you are a batter, if that cadence isn't just right.
Here comes the 2-0 offering. Borsari's breaking ball misses the outside corner. Count goes to 3-0 as he falls behind the leadoff batter for Leominster, Tyler Smith. And don't blink, the 3-0 comes right down the tube. Called strike, 3-1 goes the count. Smith taken all the way there, Bill Thomas.
Yeah, I mean, 3-0, you'd like to get your leadoff guy on, and that's what Leominster's done right here. Take the walk, good as a base hit.
Yeah, 3-1 goes high and outside, and it's a walk to the leadoff batter, Smith. Leominster's got the leadoff batter on. Pitch see what they can do with it.
Pitch can't find the plate. You don't want to help him out.
No, I think you'll see Leominster be very patient here in the two spot unless it's a sweet pitch. I think you'll see them be very patient, let that count get pretty deep.
I'm guessing they're not going to be bunting for one run here.
Be interesting to see if Borsari slows down a little. Well, he goes with a high kick and then the check over to first. Morrison keeping Smith close.
We'll have to see if they work that high kick or how they take advantage of the pitching motion here that we're seeing.
Borsari again, check Smith. Ooh, back just in time over at first base.
I think the only reason he was safe was the pitcher the first baseman came up a little bit. If he had waited on that, I think he would have had him at the bag.
Sean Dutton's waiting, and Borsari is just connected to Smith over at first. First offering, called strike on the outside, and just scurrying back in is Smith at first. Bill Thomas, not often that you have a catcher bat leadoff. He gets on drawing the walk, and of course, catchers now aren't power guys. He's not your prototypical catcher.
Prototypical catcher, for sure. And if you hadn't told me he was the catcher, I wouldn't have guessed. More like a second baseman, which is your atypical leadoff hitter.
Borsari settles in and checks Smith back over to first once again. Very deliberate has Borsari been thus far.
A little bit of dancing around at first base there.
The 0-1, they try to bunt. Dutton not able to lay it down.
And I'm all done.
Get the
baseball, softball.
I'm all done coaching.
Get the bunt down.
Doesn't matter the sport, bunting. The lost art of the bat ball sport.
Yeah. Get the bunt down.
In the hole, 0-2 is Dutton.
You knew that was going to be. You knew that was coming to me.
Right down the tube, fouled off. Dutton stays alive.
Got no choice but to swing away now. Two strikes.
And he'll face another 0-2 offering from Borsari.
Got to protect. I want to watch for the breaking ball here. Good opportunity maybe to put the runner in motion, take advantage of what they might try to do.
The 0-2 pitch. Lined on the one hop. Played there by Richie as he gets the out at second. On the transfer was the drop. Olger Holm was able to hang on for the force out at second on the fielder's choice. And then lost it on the transfer trying to come around the bag.
Yeah, no argument there from the Leominster coaches. He's trying to go from glove to hand and a little too quick. I think he had plenty of time there to turn that, but worried about the runner getting down first baseline.
6-4 goes the put out for the first out of the inning on Smith. Dutton reaches on the fielder's choice at first and gets checked back over. And that brings Evan McCarthy. Assumption bound, scholarship winner, the designated hitter to the plate for Leominster. Snap back over Borsari. Awfully concerned, Bill Thomas, with what's going on over
at
first base.
Quick pickoff move, though. I think he's going to get one before the night's over. But, yeah, you know, you don't want too much of a distraction, especially this early in the game.
First offering to McCarthy comes 3/4, called strike on the edge.
A little funny spinner there. Almost like a slurve, half curve.
Yeah, definitely got a couple of different
arm angles.
Wasn't
that full spinner. A little break and down and away from the batter caught the outside corner.
Borsari's 0-1 offering. Breaking ball on the outside, called strike, and he got him over at first base.
I could see that.
Dutton picked off. Nice job by Bush. Snaps the ball on over, and he was scurrying. The slide came up short. Bill Thomas tried to scurry in.
He got caught in the Velcro over there.
Indeed.
You got a little too far off base.
Now Leominster finds themselves in an 0-2 count with two outs here. Difficult to...
2-3, the put out there for Bush to Morrison. High and outside, Borsari wastes that one away.
Working with two strikes, might as well give him one of those teasers.
Interesting first inning thus far for both sides. And now Borsari comes with the 1-2. Looks for the edge, through the batter's box, missed. Levels the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
I'm certain that now the Blue Devils' first base runners are going to be on their toes because the show
was... Much more conservative.
Showed that they're not afraid to throw
called
the ball
strike
around.
3 on the outside
Burr
corner.
Ball.
And away goes the Blue Devils in the first. Got the leadoff batter on relative to a walk. And other than that, it's no runs, no hits, no errors, none ultimately left on as Leominster lost a couple in that one. So no runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on base there in the top of the first. Through one here on RFM, it's Nashoba and Leominster. Knotted at nothing. A break and we're back with more. This is RFM. to historic Doyle Field in Leominster, heading into the top of the second inning. 5-6-7 due up here for the Nashoba baseball team. It's the designated hitter, Peter Ward. Peter Olgerholm and the pitcher, James Borsari, will round out the expected three for Nashoba here in the top of the second inning. Well, Bill Thomas, we said it kind of off the top. Kate and I were talking a little bit about it, and I think as the old adage goes, pitching tends to be ready in the early season a lot earlier than hitting does tend to be.
Well, Leominster did score 7 runs in their first game. I don't know what the pitching situation was there on the other side of the you know,
the
diamond, but
you know, hitter number 14,
in the springtime, yeah, when it's cold, it's a little tougher on the hitters. But we'll have to see. You know, one inning doesn't tell the story of a game. I'll say that. Todd getting a...
We're being accosted.
Of course.
This accosted.
And going back to the Dirt Dogs, you get a lot of distractions. We'll just say that. Good distractions. Trust me.
No,
they're good distractions.
Hey, it's great to see people out at the ballpark
of the fan
again.
Base.
Absolutely.
You know, when we're in a press box, we don't get that interaction.
Oh, yes, we do.
Well...
And here comes Ryan Harris's first delivery of the second, called strike on the outside corner to Peter Ward.
We've seen a lot more this year where we've created our own press boxes with the fans, which I've really embraced.
Seen a little generosity there on the outside corner.
Yeah, that outer edge on the river. Here comes the 0-1 offering. Cut on and missed there by Ward. Goes in the hole, 0-2, does the designated hitter. Kate, this is one of those things for designated hitters, softball we call it the designated player, either way. That player that doesn't get to play the field, it's hard to get in a rhythm when your only responsibility is to hit when your time comes up. The 0-2 offering, cut on and missed.
A couple of curveballs right there, puts him down.
If you don't like defense, then you're fine, right?
Second baseman, number 8, Peter.
Quick first out, especially with that number 4 hitter. You like to be able to get that out so that you can get to the, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Take a second to breathe after you get by that 4 spot.
And here comes the second baseman, Olgerholm. One out here in the top of the second. Harris, nice frame there by Smith on the outside corner. Call the strike.
I would live out there all night.
Certainly no reason to come in.
Not with that generosity. That river is like the Rio Grande right now.
Here comes the 0-1. Sweeping, nice, breaking pitch, called strike on the outside.
He's got both pitches working now. He's got that strikeout, I think, with 2 out of 3 curveballs, and he's quick to come to the curveball here, second pitch of the sequence.
A 3-pitch strikeout at that.
Yeah.
I want to talk about, we were talking about Tyler Smith, the catcher earlier, not the prototypical. We'll talk about why. Breaking pitch to the outside, fought off down the right field line. Leominster giving chase. And that will get down for a foul ball, 0-2. Bill Thomas, Tyler Smith, you talked about it, saying maybe not the prototypical look, but you'll notice he's working that new age catching. You know, before it was taught,
You're so old.
You were on your feet, you know, you're on the balls of your feet, always up, or you were sitting back, you know, in a crouch. They get down to one knee now. They try to give the umpire a great look.
The Tony Pena look.
Absolutely. And now it is like the thing.
It is. Because you want to be able to frame it. You want to let the umpire get a good look at it.
Requires more pliability. Here comes the 0-2. Wasted off the corner. 1-2 goes the count.
And I think it lets you, you know, move around a little bit as far as setting up a good target. And not just shifting your glove, you're shifting your body. You're good in good position for blocking ball.
1-2 pitch. Misses in the dirt. 2-2.
Working that outside corner. You got a couple of generous calls. Now he's trying to live out there. Nashoba batter not biting.
Trying to get him to chase. Here comes the 2-2. Down and away.
Working
count runs full.
Back, yeah.
You know, you mess around, you don't go right after him, you waste a couple of pitches, next thing you know,
you're in trouble.
You're looking at a walk, and you don't want to give him base runners.
The 3-2 pitch. Called strike 3 on the outside corner, and Smith sold it, pulled it, got up, and started to snap the ball around the field.
Didn't hesitate, didn't wait for the umpire to make the call.
The
he was calling it for him,
James,
and he gets
Borsari.
The call.
2 up and 2 down thus far here in the top of the second. And here comes James Borsari, the pitcher, hitting for himself.
I like to see a pitcher hit.
So who on defense is not hitting, Todd? Do you
do
we
I do know
realize
the answer to
that?
This question. Yeah, center fielder.
Center fielder, Arsenal.
Arsenal's not
batting. Of course, designated hitter doesn't have to be for the pitcher, although it always, most always is in the upper levels.
1-0 pitch, call the strike. Corsari's count evens at 1-1.
Two distinct different pitching styles, too. Harris here, full windup, attack mode.
The 1-1. Down and away. Two balls and a strike.
Both pitchers working very quickly.
Indeed.
Like to see that.
Got a nice cadence.
Yeah, Nashoba's pitcher, fast. John David Bissett says, hi, Todd.
John's in attendance tonight up the baseline. Here comes the 2-1. Called strike on the outside corner, and the count evens again at 2-2.
Deuces are wild.
Indeed, indeed they are.
All the way across the board. Second in, two strikes, two balls.
I had to.
Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Top of the second inning, the 2-2 pitch. Down and away, count runs full again.
Got to be careful with these full counts. Before you know it, the pitch count's going to start working against you. You know, you don't want to have 20 pitch innings and second full count here that Harris has had to deal with here in the second inning.
Here comes the 3-2 pitch from Harris. Ground ball up the middle, fielded by the shortstop, Massa. On to first and not in time. Had a little trouble getting that one out of the glove, Bill Thomas.
Yeah, that's going to go as an E6. I think he tried to rush it a little bit there. It's not a very hard hit ball. Had to make a quick pick and snap. I just couldn't quite get the handle on it.
So a base runner late here in the second for Nashoba. Borsari now on at first. Josh Morrison will come to the plate, the 8-hole hitter. And that's going to send Harris into the stretch. Sweeping breaking ball popped up to the right side of the infield and called and caught by the first baseman, Brandon Arsenal, to end the top of the second. No runs, no hits, no errors. One left on for Nashoba's baseball team. That's the top of the second. This is high school baseball on RFM.
And on Twitter at Leominster Football at LHS Blue Devils FB and also Leominster Athletics on Twitter. Watch for any game change updates via those social media platforms.
Bottom of the second inning here at Doyle Field in Leominster. Slots 4, 5, 6, two up for Leominster here in the bottom of the second. It's Nick Garcia, Brandon Arsenal, and Tony Sabatelli all due up here in the second.
Number 8, Nick Garcia.
Nolan Bush trots back to the plate, gets ready to take a look at Borsari. We'll see what he got here. I have come to notice, by the way, two center fielders listed on the lineup card for Nashoba, and nobody in the left field slot. So that concerns me. There's no 7 listed on the lineup. We have 2 8s for positions and no 7s. First pitch called, the strike. Second catches the outside corner as well, and quickly in the hole goes Garcia, 0-2. Borsari wasting no time getting on top of the cleanup hitter. The 0-2 offering pumps it by him, cut on and missed.
Didn't waste any time right there. Both pitches.
That's about as efficient. He's had two.
That's assembly line efficient.
Strikeouts. And within like 15 seconds between, like, it's been fast.
He's got somewhere to go.
Yeah, Henry Ford is very impressed right now.
Yes,
no question
that's right.
About that.
That is Henry Ford's genius.
Indeed it was. Here comes Arsenal to the plate. Shows bunt, pulls it back, called the strike.
Borsari's definitely dealing.
If I'm Leominster's coaching staff, I'm letting my hitters know he's found the strike zone. time to swing.
Yeah, here comes the 0-1 offering. A little break on that one. Cut on and missed. 0-2.
Nice curveball in the outside corner right there. Yeah, you're right, Kate. You get up there ready to swing because yep. nothing worse than a first pitch strike. Putting you in the hole because you're looking.
He struggled early in the first inning,
First pitcher. Yeah. First batter, you're correct.
He's found it now, so now you got to.
Well, a couple of three-pitch strikeouts will help your confidence, too.
That's right.
Count goes to 1-2. Here comes Borsari's 1-2 offering. High and outside. Count levels at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
The other thing is he's taking advantage of a generous strike zone on the outside and on the upper edge as well.
The 2-2. Cut on and missed in the dirt. It'll be strike 3 and the put out on the drop. Third strike at first goes Bush to Morrison to book a second strikeout here in the bottom of the second for Borsari.
That
brings Tony Salvatelli to the plate. And Kate, you know, you mentioned that generous outside corner. It's going to force the right-handed batters from Leominster and, by the way, on the other side, on Nashoba's side, because it's been in both cases, to either fight the ball off or they got to take it to right field. Yet another lost start. Timeout call, then Salvatelli will step out.
Yeah, you got to either throw those hands on that outside corner, especially when you have 2 strikes, or you've got to be willing to fight it off, as you said.
Borsari goes for the outside corner and missed it in the batter's box.
And he is basically toying with the umpire to see just how generous
he will
be.
You're right, he's working his way out there.
Yep. How much will you give me?
The 1-0 offering from Borsari, sweeping and missing again.
A little too far out there on that curveball. But, you know, you wonder if the Leominster hitters will start inching a little closer to the plate to get that inch or two back on the outside corner that the umpire
2-0 pitch, checked but went. Called strike at the plate, 2 balls and a strike. The 2-1 offering from Borsari to Salvatelli. Checked the swing up again. Called the ball away. They check down at first, and they ring it up for a strike.
Two.
Count will go to 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Didn't see that coming.
The 2-2 offering.
Right off the end of the
bat.
A
cue shot fielded by Bush on to first. 2-3 goes the put out. 3 up and 3 down in the inning for the Blue Devils.
A little swinging bunt right there.
Indeed. No runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody on, let alone left on. Through two here from Doyle Field, it's Leominster nothing and Nashoba nothing. More to come. This is Baseball on RFM. Back to Doyle Field here on RFM. 9 to the top for the Nashoba baseball team here in the top of the third. So that's Arsenault Richie Klinkhammer due up in the inning. For Arsenault, it'll be his first opportunity at the plate against Harris. Meanwhile, then we go back to the top of the order. Richie had a single to open the ballgame. It's been the only hit thus far. And then Klinkhammer with a backward K, retired looking in inning number one. Arsenal comes to the plate as Leominster retakes their positions. And that brings the lefty Arsenal in that last spot, the 9 spot, to the plate. First lefty we've seen all day, which will be interesting because the pitchers have been favoring this side of the plate. We'll see what they do here as Harris starts the top of the third, going to the outside, misses away to the lefty arsenal.
You think he'd try to stay on where he's been successful, just come inside. Pitch him on the hands.
Yeah, easier said than done.
Arsenal's going to force him. He's got the toes to the line. Here goes the 1-0, fouled up and out of play.
Oh, that had glass.
That was, I believe, Dick Tucker.
Who did it get?
I believe it was a sound effect.
Honestly, no, was that what it was? No,
I believe
looking.
That was a Dick Tucker sound effect.
Ouch. My word.
Glad we're parked where we are. Here comes Harris's 1-1.
There goes another one.
That one just stayed in play. Fouled off. You know, I always promised if I was going to get into calling baseball on a full-time opportunity, I'd bring a glove, Kate. I did not have the glove with me.
We don't have enough. At this point. We
don't have enough room to be able to do that. Here comes Harris's 1-2 pitch. Fought off. Garcia with the pirouette move on to first in time over at first base retire Arsenal.
What a play over there by the third baseman and a nice pick by the first baseman.
Lead-off
batter all around.
Shortstop number 2, Stephen Ritchie.
Yeah, 5-3 goes the putout, and that looks awfully common given the great play that was made by Garcia on his way over to Arsenal at first.
We're back to the top, right?
Yes, indeed. Back to Ritchie. 1-of-1 on the day. Had the lone single of the ball game. Second time through the order for Harris, comes high across the letters, called the ball.
I think the umpire was thinking about it, too. He thought about it. I could see it.
Harris's 1-0 offering, high again, 2-0.
I got to tell you, I'm not a big fan of the umpire crouching over the top of the catcher. I like an umpire that kind of gets down in the catcher's eyes.
In the slot.
Yeah, got to get in the slot. The Davis box,
exactly.
Very common today.
You can't be afraid to be inside.
2-0 call, the strike on the outside corner for Harris. One of the things I don't like about the Davis box, Bill Thomas, we're going to get into the discussion of the umpire stance, is that it leaves you right over the catcher, which is the exit zone of all foul balls going straight
exactly.
back. That's a called strike on the outside corner to level the count to Ritchie at 2-2.
But the situation with the Davis box is as you age, it's a little bit easier to be able to lock
never
into
heard
position.
It called as a Davis box.
Jerry Davis,
yeah,
Major League Baseball umpire, he patented it. The 2-2 pulled foul outside of third base.
Never heard that before.
Yeah.
Can you mute me?
Kate? I can.
Kate's got an uh-oh. What happened?
Aha. Uh-huh.
We okay?
Good now.
Kate had a little power problem. The broadcast may have come crashing down. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Popped up over to the right side, foul territory. Arsenal giving chase, and that one lost into the grandstand.
We'll call
down
that
the third
out of
base
play
sign.
Somewhere
yeah.
down there in no man's land.
Another 2-2 offering coming up for Ritchie.
Luckily, when the power starts to go, I saw the dim, and I was like,
"Oh, it started powering down to save
the
last 5%."
Luckily, I had about a minute.
Big save. Mission impossible.
If you only knew what it takes to keep this all together. There's duct tape. Miss MacGyver, that's
twine.
Me.
Indeed.
Bailing wire.
Hey, there's lamps now. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Breaking pitch. Yes. Check on a first. Ring it up.
He didn't even wait.
He knew he swung. Yep, I agree.
He's like, yeah, I'm headed to the dugout.
Two up, two down thus far here in the top of the third. And that brings Justin Klinkhammer, the center fielder, to the plate.
Something smells amazing.
This is a Mexican restaurant. I'm telling you, I'm going to go for burritos over here. Since they made the rail trail, it's like opened up a whole new world.
Yeah, you know, it almost,
steak.
I was going to say, it's definitely steak. It has that kind of Fenway Park feel to
it.
You know,
like,
you got to get all the
snack?
Vendors
is there
on
a
the
food
street.
Truck around here somewhere?
Smells good. Smell-o-vision.
Two outs here in the top of the third.
Looking for the popcorn.
Cut on and missed. Klinkhammer has been struggling facing Harris thus far today. He got called out looking in his first at bat, 0-1 for the day. Now here comes Harris on the 0-1 offering. Right down the middle with a little breaking ball. Cut on and missed yet again. Klinkhammer is all thrown off.
Still indecisive. Even though it was a curveball, it looked like a late swing right there. Just not really sure what to do.
and mentally getting this far into a hole can be tricky to dig out of, especially when he didn't have a great first at bat.
High and wide for the 0-2 pitch. Runs the count to 1-2.
Now you can breathe for a second here.
Still, you got to watch out for that that sweeper. It's going to get you fishing on the outside corner here.
You got some room. Got to try to avoid the chase. The 1-2 in the dirt. Levels the count at 2-2.
Good patience. Like you were saying, Kate, sometimes you get in that protect mode and you get overly protective, and next thing you know,
trouble.
There's nothing left to protect.
That's right. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. High and outside. Runs the count full. Klinkhammer's got himself in trouble a little bit on a couple of occasions. He's had multiple 3-2 counts over the last couple of innings. Got a batter looking and then ended up giving up a hit on an error. Now another 3-2 offering. Come on and missed.
Good way to come right after him there. Get that third out of the inning.
No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left on in the top of the third for the Chieftains. Back-to-back K's to end the top of the third. Blue Devils come back to bat through 2.5. Bottom of the third inning, no score. Leominster and Nashoba here on a Saturday night, concluding a triple header thus far. And Kate, you're pointing to a very important number right now for James Borsari. Not only does he work quickly, he hasn't had to throw many pitches.
Yeah, fairly efficient. He's 23 pitches in as opposed to Leominster's pitcher, who's 43 pitches into this ball game. So efficient, effective, bottom of the third. He's doing a nice job.
And he's faced the minimum thus far. 6 batters, 7, 8, 9 due up in the inning for Leominster. That pitch called a strike to open the bottom of the third. It's Martinez, Durkin, and Massa due up for Leominster here. And this is Nico Martinez at the plate, the left fielder. Waves in another one from Borsari.
I got to tell you, that first pitch strike wakes a hitter up. Mm-hmm. It'll get you swinging.
And it's not going well from there.
No.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Cut on and missed.
Wow.
Another three-pitch strikeout right there.
Coming Borsari cruising
right now.
He's
got somewhere to go.
And I think that's home with a win. That's the goal.
Well, and the other thing is he can be aggressive. He's feeling it right now, and he's got 7-8-9 in the batting order for Leominster. So, I mean, you're going up against 7-8-9, and you've been feeling it in the middle of the order. I'm being aggressive if I'm a pitcher. I'm going right at every batter.
What would be the deterrent? Maybe the lefty Eamon Durkin. Comes with a three-quarter breaking ball there, and that one drifts high and wide. Ball one to Durkin.
Another left-handed batter here.
Leominster's first thus far in their lineup. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Sweeping, fouled up, and out of play.
It's a sound effect.
It is most definitely.
That time
nobody
was.
Believes me, but that's a sound effect from the one and only Dick Tucker.
Sounded too good.
The best
time.
Part is he looks behind him. He plays it up over there.
Of course
every
he does.
Time it happens.
The 1-1 pitch grounded on to first. Fielded by Morrison. Steps on the bag there. Mark that one 3 unassisted for out number 2. And that brings Nick Massa to the plate, the 9-hole hitter, the shortstop. Got to imagine, Bill Thomas, when you put the shortstop in the 9-hole and the catcher in the 1-hole, you're thinking double leadoff here. You want to have two players to come up often and able to really invigorate that offense. First offering to Massa. Borsari gets called for a strike.
You got to be ready to swing when you're coming up to the plate tonight, because first pitch strikes are going to...
0-1 becomes 0-2 with the sweeping breaking ball.
They're going to become problematic.
And I think Leominster spending a little too much time thinking. Got to foul this one off. The 0-2 cut on and missed.
Another three-pitch strikeout.
There goes another inning for the Blue Devils offense. Borsari is through three innings, having faced nine batters, the absolute minimum, through the first three. Through three here from Doyle Field, it's Leominster nothing, Nashoba nothing. More to come. This is High School Baseball on RFM. To the top of the fourth we go for Nashoba. And at this point, Nashoba going to go 3-4-5 here in the fourth. So it's Bush, Salmon, and Ward. Two flyouts and a strikeout. That's what's coming to the plate for Ryan Harris. Pitching has been the name of the game thus far in this one.
Both pitches fairly efficient.
It's the top of the fifth, correct?
Fourth.
Fourth.
Top of the fourth. Okay.
Kate got a little overzealous.
Good to know. It's like, that doesn't look great.
I feel like that was going a little quick. All right, here we go.
I'm like, we're already in the fifth.
Here comes Harris's first offering at the top of the fourth. Misses high and inside to Nolan Bush.
Girl can hope.
You should be happy we're in the top of the fourth.
It's going like fast.
Back end of a triple header. Softball, we'd still be exchanging the lineup cards. Harris has to step off the back. Recent note, a game that used to be 90 minutes long now takes almost 3 hours. It's ridiculous.
Red Sox had 4 hours and 10 minutes the other day, though.
Yeah, that's about average. Here comes the 1-0 pitch.
A little low.
Down low, misses. 2-0 goes the count. Smith looks over to the dugout. Assistant coach Ed Voles with the signals. 2-0 offering.
Coming
popped
back.
Up and out of play long. 2-1 the count to Bush leading off here in the top of the fourth. He had the fly out to third base in his first at bat. A 2-1 from Harris. Fisted off straight up the middle, giving chase. It's Massa. He'll corral, sling it on to first. Not in time. An infield single for Bush.
Third baseman number three, Connor Salmon.
Good speed getting down the first baseline there. Kind of a funny dribbler that got over the second base bag.
And so that brings Connor Salmon to the plate.
Massa not able to make the play.
Now we'll see how concerned.
Now, do you play for one run here? I think you might
want to
think about it.
One run feels like it might rue the day today.
You might want to think about it now.
First offering in the dirt, knocked down by Smith, and he kept it in front of him. Great play there, giving up the shoulder.
Yeah, good job right there by the catcher, Smith. Very active back there. Jumped out in front of that one. Most catchers will just try to stick the glove out there and then be chasing it. Good job right there by Smith.
Nashoba looking for a hit here out of their number four batter to move that runner.
The fly out to center to close the first. This one popped out, and he's screaming for it to get out of play. And it will successfully make it out of play.
Yeah, you're not going to expect your cleanup hitter to be bunting right here. So
nobody's got
to they're playing for a run, but not that way.
Yeah, got to make contact.
They're playing for two runs
to move that
That's
runner
what they're
around,
looking
though.
For.
Under the lights on the upper field, Leominster's baseball field here at historic Doyle Field, and great to have you with us on a Saturday night, closing out a triple header on opening day of the spring season. An opening day Saturday, check over to first, and back in plenty of time is Bush.
I have to say the field looks beautiful.
Oh, well, does it ever.
The Parks Department does a fantastic job.
Credit Pat LaPointe personally. I see him
Absolutely.
Out here all the time walking and checking the grass. That one sweeps and catches the outside corner for a strike. Salmon in the hole, one ball and two strikes.
If I'm a right-handed batter, I need to throw my hands.
Now we need a lot more foul balls, you're thinking,
throw
off this first baseline.
My hands.
Harris sneaks a peek over at Bush over at first. Comes set. And he'll snap it on over. Hand back in for Bush. 1-2 count, nobody out here in the top of the fourth. Nashoba would like to find a gap, see if they can move this runner. At least 90 feet, maybe a little bit more. Base hit, especially up that gap, Bill Thomas, with a lot of room. The 1-2 pitch, chopped, foul outside of third base.
Kick foul on that last bounce right before the third base bag.
Nice job by the umpire
nice to
get out there and get on
Jumping
the line.
Jumping out there, absolutely. Nothing like a lazy umpire that doesn't get off from behind
that
the
plate.
That
misses that angle. He
absolutely.
Got right on top of it.
He was on it before the ball was anywhere near the third base bag.
That's some nice hustle.
Absolutely. One ball, two strikes, the count on Connor Salmon. Cleanup hitter. Like you said, Kate, this would be the person you would want at bat in this kind of a situation.
Need him to make contact here, especially with two strikes.
Harris stares in, now checks on over at first. Arsenault keeping Bush close. And Harris is going to snap over again in a nice dig by Arsenault. He had to go backhand there to make the play. And it was back between the cleats. He was able to keep it in front and collected.
Harris putting the ball right on the bag, though, on that pickoff move.
The 1-2 pitch going on the pitch. Smith snaps down to second, sliding in. Cut down at second base.
Right.
And Smith just shaking his head going, you don't steal on me. Or maybe it was more like, because he kind of rolled his eyes at himself.
Like, oh.
Maybe it was like, I double clutched that one and still got away with it.
He threw a strike to second base, though. Nice tag. I didn't see who was covering there, if it was Massa, but whoever covered the bag there, good job getting the tag down.
We'll go 2-4 on the putout for the first out of the inning. Now the 2-2 offering, sweeping breaking pitch floated high. And that'll run the count full, three balls and two strikes. Gotta love it when your catcher helps you out as a pitcher. Here comes Harris's 3-2 offering to Salmon. And that one drifts high and outside, a walk for Nashoba and Salmon. So now let's talk about the logic of this one. Let's go to the bat ball coach. Timeout taken on the field. Coach Voles is going to go out and talk to his pitcher, Harris. And, Kate, let's talk about the logic here. You've got Salmon, the cleanup hitter at the plate.
Yep.
Count was in his favor.
Yep.
You send the runner.
Yep.
You're not protecting him with a swing at the plate because
nope,
you're going to give
strikes.
It up.
Yep.
You take the bat out of the hands,
yep.
at least the opportunity, if you will, out of the hands of your cleanup
later,
hitter.
You get a walk, you would have had two men on and one out.
Two on with
I mean,
nobody
no
out.
Out.
No out.
Instead, you have one man on with one out.
And, of course, it's all about, you know, your feelings, situations, tendencies. I mean, you're not playing money ball here. You know, it's high school baseball. Nobody's checking the percentages. You know, so Coach Schoolcraft.
Sure?
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean,
maybe
sure?
maybe the math department. You never know. Check in with the math department out at Nashoba to find out. But Coach Voles out there having an extended discussion here. I got to imagine this is called What Do You Do With Ward, the designated hitter. Didn't bat in the first, came up in the second as the leadoff batter, and you got him swinging to end that at bat. But this is your second time through the order. Touched up a little bit more here, Harris has
now
been.
Now you manufacture a run.
Well, you got to think about it at this point. but you've already given up the out in the inning. Salmon at first, Arsenal will hold them, which creates the hole on the right. They'll snap it on over to push him on back to first base. And the DH, Ward, is at the plate, 0 of 1 on the day with a swinging strikeout.
See some action down in the Blue Devils bullpen there. We got a lefty warming up. I can't get a number, but we do got some action in the pen.
Check over to first, and that one hit the runner. I thought that had gotten wide.
Got
yeah, but got lucky. That one in the dirt and hit the runner. Harris laboring a little bit here in the fourth.
Lucky and hit the runner in the same.
Well, I mean, in that it didn't end up down the first base line, that's for sure.
I'm not happy.
Here comes Harris's delivery. First offering is down and away. Ward goes ahead in the count 1-0. And serious. You can see Harris starting to labor a little bit. And that pitch count, Kate, now up over 50.
Absolutely. Started the inning at 53.
Lined straight back up the box and into center field. Dutton up with it. Everybody moves 90 feet.
Now that stolen base becomes really big.
Because you would have bases loaded with nobody out.
Exactly. Folger home.
One out, two men on.
Indeed.
Number six hitter coming up here, Olger Holm.
And Olger Holm was caught looking in his first at-bat, so he's 0 of 1 on the day. But we've seen runners having more success, second time through the order here, these batters having much more success against Ryan Harris. Blue Devils defense tries to get behind Harris, sweeping curveball, call the strike.
Harris just, it's not the same pitcher when he's working out of the stretch. The distractions, just getting him off his game a little bit, I think, worrying about the base runners.
Well, and now with that lead runner behind him in his blind spot, got to think about, he's going to try to snap it around. No, and actually he thinks about going to first. There's a timeout called, and that is a balk. He fainted to first, and he didn't release the ball. Balk called against Harris, and everybody moves 90 feet.
You can do that when you step back off the rubber before you make that move.
When you snap the quick move, you've got to give it up.
He made that move off the on the rubber, and even if you just lob it over there, we've even seen the pitchers roll the ball over there as an afterthought.
But something's better than nothing.
Mental mistake right there by Harris, and just a pure distraction by the base runners.
Early in the season, didn't have a season last year. Yeah. You won't make that mistake again.
Yeah, now two runners in scoring position for Nashoba, and this one misses high. Levels the count at 1-1.
Got to be careful now.
Yes, indeed.
But you will play. I see the infield's playing in. That's... Thought maybe they might play an out
gonna
for a run.
Going to try to cut the run down here at the plate.
Looking at
high and in.
How important one run might be tonight.
Two balls and a strike to Olger Holm.
Especially the way Borsari's been dealing.
And you notice down in that bullpen, the warm-up is starting to get a little bit quicker down there.
I wish I had a number. It's a lefty. I don't know what their roster looks like. But, he's a sense of urgency down there in the Blue Devil bullpen.
As Harris is starting to come to the end of this outing. Here comes the 2-1 pitch. Breaking, sawed off chop, fielded. Bush's only play is to first, Smith, and it's in time.
Looked like that ball was going to spin foul, and it's just died in that loose dirt right there.
From
just
the number 24, James Borsari.
Just inside the foul line there on the fair ball side. Nice play by Smith.
And that became fortuitous for the Leominster defense there. That gets them out of a bit of a jam with two outs now.
Changes everything because now the defense can go back to their normal positioning.
And both outs have come from the catcher, Smith. Yep. Cut down a runner at second base earlier in the inning. Now fielded the swinging bunt right out in front of the plate, up and on to first base, and he held the runner at third.
Not what you're hoping for if you're coaching staff.
Not ideal, but here you are. Borsari, the pitcher, comes to the plate with two outs here in the top of the fourth. Chopping ground ball in the gap, bobbled by Garcia. No play to be made. Run scores. Now thrown away over at third as Massa wasn't able to field it. And the Chieftains on the balk, and then a subsequent ground ball able to score a run. Probably an error there as well as not able to field it over there at third. Garcia. But
official
really
scorer puts it up as an E on the scoreboard.
Yes.
I have it as an error as well.
And definitely score that on the balk. Move that runner, that extra 90 feet and around it goes.
Right there, but still counts.
Goes down as an E5.
Runners on the corner now for Nashoba.
I fully expect to send the runner here.
Yeah, make him make a choice.
Try to get something going. Even to steal a run here, get a runner, just put him in motion and try to get Leominster to throw the ball around a little bit.
Especially defensively, they've been a little bit choppy, so make them make a play. See if they can make a mistake.
First delivery to Morrison. You know, misses high.
And this changes the whole situation for the pitch sequence. Now, you got to be careful with the curveball. The last thing you want is a ball in the dirt that could lead to a run. But, you know, you got to be aware of that runner on first base also. You just don't want to give him second base. But, you know, he's looking at it.
1-0 pitch. Misses the outside corner. Count goes to 2-0. Imagine this. The pitcher Borsari in his two at-bats has reached base both times. An error on the shortstop in the first at-bat. An error on the third baseman scores a run in his second at-bat.
Yeah, he hasn't hit the ball all that hard, but he's put it in play, which is
First
and foremost.
Good things happen.
Absolutely.
Right.
Don't put the ball in play. Nothing happens.
Harris, the arm hanging a little bit, laboring here in the fourth, touched up for a run.
Middle infield pinching the middle.
2-0 pitch, gets away from Smith, and that's a wild pitch that will score yet another, and it's 2-0 Nashoba.
Curveball lets Harris down right there. I thought he'd stay with the fastball where he's struggling, but trying to stay with that mix of pitches, and curveball just lets him down right there. Two big runs the way Borsari's been dealing, too. Going to have to come up swinging at those first pitch strikes so the Blue Devils get back on offense.
3-0, the count at the plate to Morrison. Borsari moves 90 feet up to second on the run scored.
The action's done down in the bullpen, so I'm guessing that pitch is ready if they decide to make a move here. This could be the last hitter that Harris faces if he loses him.
Especially in the with the eight batter up.
And this fourth inning is what's going to make this pitching line look awfully ugly. The 3-0 pitch gets away again from Smith and allows Borsari to move up on the walk.
Things are
spiraling.
Turning from bad to worse, and I think we're going to get a pitching change.
Indeed we are. Here comes head coach Rich Barnaby out of the dugout, and he's going to have to pull the trigger. Pitching change here at Doyle Field. 2-0 Nashoba here in the top of the fourth. We step aside. This is RFM. Out of the bullpen comes the lefty, Ryan Garner. Garner, tall, lanky, left-hander, comes in, closed the book on Harris. Harris, 3 2/3, 2 hits, 2 runs. They were not earned. 2 walks, 5 strikeouts in that line. Bill Thomas, you take the fourth inning out of it. Ryan Harris had a pretty good outing.
Yeah, I mean, but, you know, he struggled, especially when he had to pitch out of the stretch. And the Nashoba hitters were patient. Put a couple of balls in play, and Blue Devils couldn't make the play on defense.
All right, Todd Robbins, do we have a story about Ryan Garner?
Oh, do we have a story? Well, we've got lots
of
stories.
Do we know, the last name's familiar. Do
it
we know?
Is.
Yes,
do we know
is.
Who he is by
Garner's
any chance?
First offering is called a strike as he faces the 9-hole hitter, Patrick Arsenault. He is the son of recently named head coach of the Fitchburg High School Red Raiders, Chad Garner. The runner goes in the midst of it all.
Run.
And they will successfully do it. Garner throws on down to second. The run scores from third. Now caught in a rundown. Back and forth. It will end the inning, but the run scores on the timing play.
Nashoba tacks that third run on. I think that might have been a mental mistake right there, chasing that runner from first base with two outs, but we'll have to see how that plays out.
Yeah, indeed. Cut down on that one is Morrison. Ultimately goes 6-3 on the putout for the third out, but an ugly inning for the Blue Devils, to say the least, in the top of the fourth. We'll total it up and have it for you here in a moment. Bottom of the fourth, two, make it 3-0 Nashoba through 3.5. More to come. This is RFM. To the bottom of the fourth we go here at Doyle Field. Borsari has faced the minimum. First pitch missed high and outside. As we go back to the top of the order for the Blue Devils and Tyler Smith, 1-2-3 due up, Smith, Dutton, and McCarthy. Leominster trails 3-0, and Borsari misses there. Count goes to 2-0 to Tyler Smith. Smith certainly had a difficult inning of work catching Harris in that fourth. This one comes down the pipe, call the strike.
Now you want to see the Blue Devils kind of work the pitch count here a little bit, but Basari's been so spot on with first pitch strikes, it makes it awful difficult.
2-1 offering. Smith tries to bunt out of his reach, and the count goes to 2-2.
Out of everybody's reach right there. Pitch was wide and low.
If you know it's that far out, you got to bring that back.
Here comes Borsari's 2-2 offering. Just a shade outside. Runs the count full, 3-2.
That was close considering how generous that river's been on the outhand outside of the plate.
Smith gets the 3-2 offering, pops it up toward right center, giving chase. That will fall in. He's around first and stand up into second. And he says, come on, to his dugout. A stand-up double for Tyler Smith to open the bottom of the fourth.
Perfectly placed right center field between the right fielder and center fielder. Picked up by the right fielder, but nice hustle right there to get second base. Turn that into a hustle double.
And a couple of things. If you're Leominster, number one, that's how you want to start the inning. But also, that's the player that you want to get things started with the top of their order up here in the bottom of the fourth.
Borsari checking Smith out at second. Farthest a runner has gotten, he steps off the back.
Well, and Smith now becomes a very important run because Leominster needing to manufacture here when you get that.
First offering to Dutton is called the strike.
When you get that leadoff runner on base, especially with a multiple base hit, you need to make something happen here when you're down by three.
Dutton reached on a fielder's choice in his first at bat. Here comes the 0-1 pitch on the corner for a called strike.
Well, sorry, dealing right now.
He's having to do a little thinking, though, with Smith in that blind spot.
He's a fast worker, though.
Yeah, no doubt. 0-2, grounded, up with it. No, booted over at third base by Salmon. It stays in front of the runner. Gets another one on for Leominster. That will go down as an E5. Leominster, all of a sudden showing a little bit of a spark. 2-1 to start this fourth inning for them on the offensive side.
You see just a little bit of a chink in the armor now with two runners on and no outs.
Still only 40 pitches face. Steps off the back, snaps it at the second baseman, Ogerholm, who comes running in to make the play there as he's playing almost straight over second base's Ogerholm, just a shade over.
You can see that middle infield pinching the middle.
First offering, ground ball finds the gap. An up around second is Smith on his horse. Throw into home will not be in time. And Leominster is on the board. The stand-up double for Tyler Smith. And around and in he goes. And the Blue Devils are on the board. Good things happen when you put the ball in play.
And a good heads-up run in there, too, by, who is that, McCarthy at the plate?
Yes.
Ends up on second base on that throw to the plate, which never really had a chance to get the runner. But good advance on that throw over the cutoff man by the left fielder.
Single and advances on the
single
throw,
Single and
Thomas.
Advance
See,
on
I,
the throw.
Yeah, I thought you'd like that.
Yeah, you got the terminology down.
Hey,
See,
you know.
It's all coming back to you now. But, there was no chance there, and they just gave him that second base for free, basically. We have to see if the Blue Devils can take advantage of it. He had two runners in scoring position.
Nashoba will take the timeout here to try to settle things down. Cleanup hitter Nick Garcia coming to the plate. Garcia saw three pitches in his first at-bat, waved them all. So he is 0-1 with a swinging strikeout.
But we're seeing a little different attitude here second time through the lineup, and
attack,
you always want to get
attack.
Back yeah, for a second time around. That's what we're seeing. The Blue Devils much more aggressive here. Putting the ball in play.
It just took a while to get to the second time around. Garcia sees the first offering, called strike on the outside corner.
Yeah, plate looked big right there.
I'm glad we're at an angle because we really can't tell. But
yes, we can.
They always look better from the side. I
the
found 0-1
cut on and missed
I'm
there.
I'm going to say that was not a strike, but he swung at it anyways.
Well,
that
that's
was,
what
that was a little
ends up
more
happening.
Outside.
Kane, I want to go back a second to Smith being able to score on that one. They were trying to hold him at second. The middle infield pinched in, and then that hit found the gap where the shortstop typically would have met.
Certainly right there. It's one of those things with the, you give up something to get something. And in that situation, it does come back to bite you because they want to be able to make sure that they pinch that middle infield, keep that runner where he is. But you got a wide open gap there, even with the third baseman off the line.
1-2 offering for Basari. Sit down.
Didn't take long. Yeah, to your point, Kate, it was a good heads-up base runner by Smith, too. He had the play in front of him, but he never broke stride. And he saw that the fielder was out of position, not going to make the play.
Yep.
Nice heads-up runner from second base.
Yeah, and if you get a good jump like that, then you're from a coaching perspective, it's nice because there's no hesitation to send him home.
Six strikeouts on the day thus far for Borsari and pours another strike in as Brandon Arsenal comes to the plate. A victim swinging in his first at-bat. He's 0-1.
Stat I wish I was keeping track of was first pitch strikes, but I'm gonna guess he started off probably half of the batters with a first pitch strike so far.
And now you're in a position where you're down 0-2 with base runners on. That's not a fun position to be in when you have an opposing pitcher who's pitching so effectively.
Two on, one out. Borsari's 0-2 offering. Paints the corner for a called strike three.
You cannot wait on that one. You got to assume that although that plate is only 17 inches wide, that strike zone on an 0-2, you better get that bat off your shoulder and you better be swinging.
I think they're using the black. But we know the black is not part of the plate.
Not technically part of the plate, but I'll tell you.
When they say it's on the black, it's a ball.
Well, and if you leave it to make the decision, especially with how great the night has been going, that's called the strike.
Everybody's in a groove with that strike call. So like you said, if you leave it up
leave
to
the choice, yeah. Sit them down.
There's no such thing as a 50-50 ball.
I was going to say, there's no 50-50 ball in this circumstance. Savatelli at the plate. And he watches strike two go by.
That looked right down the middle.
Indeed it was.
And I think if you are Coach Barnaby in between innings, you're going to have a conversation. You have men on. You cannot get this far behind in a count.
This one popped up, and I'm going to lean in because I have no idea where that one went other than over our head out of play.
Apartment block complex.
Thank you, Bill Thomas.
But I think Borsari's got the Blue Devil hit is guessing wrong right now, too, you know, and because he's got two pitches working.
The 0-2 pitch high and outside. Savatelli is 0-1 on the day. He was cut down 2-3 in his first at-bat. The 1-2 offering from Borsari, breaking and fought off by Savatelli.
Another one in the parking lot.
And that's what you got to do with that outside corner. Leave nothing to chance.
You just got to toss the bat out there.
Yeah, spoil it, get the next one.
Here comes the 1-2 pitch from Borsari. Waved at it, and down he goes. Had to work a little bit harder, did Borsari, in that inning.
Two big strikeouts.
Yeah, three to end, well,
to end
the
inning.
Inning.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. But touched up for a run. Gave up a double to open the inning. Tyler Smith would come around to score. Leominster would strand two. Three straight strikeouts. Two looking, one swinging to close the fourth. Through four here at Doyle Field. It's Nashoba 3, Leominster 1. More to come. High School Baseball, RFM. To the top of the fifth we go here on Rivalry Family Media. And great to have you along with us. Todd Robbins, Bill Thomas, Kate Robbins, and you. Great to have you with us here in the top of the fifth. Shout out your favorite players. Second screen experience, facebook.com/media rivalry. Second inning of work for Ryan Garner on the bump. Comes with a called strike there as Patrick Arsenault returns for his at-bat. Garner, the lefty, with the sweeping breaking ball, fought off by Arsenault, 0-2. Leominster scored one run on two hits, an error, and left two on base in the bottom of the fourth. Garner, sweeping breaking ball, cut on. It rolls its way to the backstop as it gets away from Smith, and that'll be a pass ball that allows Arsenault to advance.
Shortstop number 2, Stephen Ritchie.
Bill Thomas, when you
enough
have outs, you
enough
can't,
trouble getting three
you
outs.
Can't,
you can't
play
give him
that
four
game.
Outs.
Yeah. Nene.
Can't give him four outs. Just leads to your woes. Looking for another run right here.
And that one chopped foul.
Get the bunt.
As we go back to the top of the order.
This is a pet peeve.
Coach Robbins has got some struggles with this inability to bunt.
This
it
is
seems
a fundamental.
So basic.
It's a fundamental that's a lost art.
Ritchie, as we go back to the top of the order, 1-of-2, had a single and then caught swinging in the third.
Get on top of the ball.
Garner with the big step on over to first, fielded low by Arsenault, and back in time is Arsenault. Lots of Arsenaults out there right now. Patrick Arsenault on
all over
at first.
The place.
Brandon Arsenault is playing first right now.
Are they friends?
Garner with the pitch. There's a bunt down on the field. Garner has to field it. Squares and throws to first. Score that one 1-3 for the putout on the fielder's choice.
And not an easy maneuver with a left-handed pitcher having to make that defensive play and then shift his feet in order to toss to first. Not an easy job.
Facing in the wrong direction when he picked that ball up.
You got it.
Can't just whirl. You got to go against the grain.
But able to move the runner now with one out, man on second.
Good looking bunt though, wasn't it, Kate?
I liked it.
I knew really you
would. That was a good looking bunt. We'll give him credit.
I was excited.
Sweeping breaking pitch does not catch the corner for the lefty Garner. And Klinkhammer comes to the plate, been struck out twice. He is 0-of-2. looking the first time up, waved at the second opportunity.
A rare ball call there on that pitch.
The 1-0 shows bunt, pulls back. It's a steal on to third. Not today. Cut down again. Smith catches another one stealing.
Nice heads-up play right there. I didn't think third baseman was going to get over there to cover in a foot race to the bag. Nice job, though. That ball was right on the bag where it needed to be.
And the pitch was called, the ball at the plate. Two outs here in the top of the fifth inning and a 2-0 count.
Kind of surprised they were trying to steal third base there. Runner in scoring position already.
2-0 pitch, gets the contact, floats it into left field in front of Martinez, and a single there for Klinkhammer.
Bill Thomas, this is two instances now with Nashoba on offense where the decision-making for the base
Nolan
running,
Bush,
getting caught stealing has cost them a run, not once, but twice.
Potential big innings.
Yep, but it has absolutely cost them two runs, unequivocally.
And Nolan Bush comes to the plate. Garner comes set. First offering, high fly ball, shallow right field, charging on it and making the catch is Eamon Durkin. And Garner gets out of the inning with a smile on his face and a little help from the defense on around
Ladies
him.
Ladies and gentlemen, to avoid injury, fans should be alert for foul balls throughout the game.
Through four and a half, here from Doyle Field, it's Nashoba 3 and Leominster 1. More to come. This is RFM. Bottom of the fifth we go, 7-8-9 for the Blue Devils here in the bottom of the fifth. Todd Robbins, Bill Thomas, Kate Robbins, and you. Great to have all of you along with us. Third game of the day here on Facebook.com/Media Rivalry. Rivalry Family Media, great to have you with us on another day, a part of our family today for a triple header on the opening day of the spring season here at historic Doyle Field. And Bill Thomas, what has been a four-season athletic season, it's been an interesting year to say the least, but dare I say it has felt just a little bit normal.
This is really the way sports is supposed to be. Springtime baseball, winter basketball, fall football. We'll be back at it come September, but this feels like normal. This feels normal.
7-8-9 for the Blue Devils. Martinez, Durkin, and Massa do up as Borsari continues, and Martinez cuts and misses to open the bottom of the fifth. Leominster chasing two in a 3-1 game. Borsari's 0-1 pitch, fouled off by Martinez, 0-2.
And once again, pitching staff for Nashoba working ahead in the count has a Leominster batter, 0-2. He has been efficient.
Indeed he has been. Here comes Borsari's 0-2 offering. Ground ball over the bag and in play. Clean single through the hole. He's going to try for two. Rounding first and dead to rights at second base.
Not a good move when you're down 3-1.
Martinez, I think they told him to locate the ball, rounding first, and got a little too aggressive, cut down going into second.
I'd like to have seen what the first base coach was waving a swinging over there. So
Mark got a single.
It's a single, and then 7-4 goes the putout. And that brings Eamon Durkin to the plate.
And you hate to run into an out on the bases first out of the inning.
Just finally felt like maybe something positive happening for Leominster, and then
absolutely
it gets cut down at second. Fly ball here for Durkin. Heads deep toward left. No, that'll fall in short. Yeah. As I got a look at it, finally it fell in front of Arsenal. So did I.
I don't think he saw it. The lights behind us here. Yeah, he might have lost it in the light band.
Perhaps a little bit on this first baseline looking out at him.
All I know, Todd, is I'm glad you're not playing left field.
Goes at a single.
But now how big is that, you know, attempt to stretch that single
well,
into
that's
a
it.
Double?
Now you're at two runners, you know, first and second.
Yeah.
Well, if the base runner had misjudged as badly as the left fielder, they would have gotten caught at second anyway.
Indeed, they might have. Snap throw back over to first to check on Durkin. If I was Borsari here with the 7-8-9, although they're starting to put the ball in play, I wouldn't be worried about a runner at first base right now. Come right at this nine-hole hitter. And that is Massa, who waved on three straight pitches in the third inning, his first at bat.
He's got the number nine hitter. He's more concerned with the runner on first base.
And
I'll have to see if the...
The runner on first is not taking an aggressive.
Breaking pitch called, strike on the outside corner.
I wouldn't expect the Blue Devils putting anything on here, not when you're down by two. That's not the run that's going to make all that much of a difference. You'd like to plate it, but
generous.
You don't want to run into an out.
That was generous.
Kate with the golf voice on. Cut on and missed there by Massa, 0-2.
Well, he's right there. I don't want to get thrown out yet. It's my first baseball game.
I was going to say, first night on RFM, first baseball game in the history of Rivalry
Family
Media. You
don't think the basketball and football officials have tipped off the
I was
going to
say,
umpires?
I think they know us.
Look out.
You don't think we're getting a reputation? Just telling it like we see it.
As I was going to say, we report, you decide. Yeah,
exactly.
And you've got a great look at it from our home plate angle here tonight. The 0-2 pitch in the dirt, dug out nicely by Nolan Bush.
I gotta tell you, for the most part, Basari's had really good control. Just a handful of balls in the dirt, and he's thrown a fairly good number of curveballs too.
1-2 offering.
A little spinner.
Cut on and missed, and down he goes. Two outs and back to the top of the order goes Leominster. Tyler Smith had a walk, doubled in his last time at bat, and a run scored. Leominster with the one runner on. It's Eamon Durkin over at first. Two outs here, bottom of the fifth, chasing two in a 3-1 game. Snap throw on over to first. Deciding to get a rundown is Durkin. He slips out and then is run down on the play to end the inning. Leominster will begin the sixth at the top of the order. Leominster runs themselves out of the inning in the bottom of the fifth. We go to the top of the sixth when we come back. This is RFM.
Leominster Blue Devil Baseball Club thanking the following sponsors, Workers Credit Union and Wyman's Liquors.
Back to historic Doyle Field in Leominster as we go to the top of the sixth and a timeout to start the inning, Kate.
Got a conversation with the first base coach for Nashoba.
Everything's good.
Lord yeah. knows what that's about.
Pearslinger is going to be good. Here we go. 4-5-6 for Nashoba here in the sixth. Sam and Ward and Olgerholm do up. And Ryan Garner gets his first look at the cleanup hitter, Salmon. Salmon flew out the center field, walked, but became a run scored in the fourth. 1-0 from Garner. Called a strike. Count levels at 1-1.
Gardner, kind of a lanky lefty. He's got that long, long lefty look. Sweeping.
The 1-1. Popped up. Garner giving chase. He waves for it. Tough angle. Goes back and makes the catch. No. Now called foul. He stabbed it and then juggled it and ends up on the ground. So it's a foul ball. That's a really exciting strike two.
Foul. Oh, yeah. He dropped it.
Yeah. He dropped it and it was on the foul side of the line. Very, very, very close. Those are one of those real tough ones, Bill Thomas. You're bookending it as an official on either side. You're a player coming in at the ball. You've got a 0% chance on the angle to be able to play it. Garner made a nice effort at it, but almost put the ball in play.
Depending how deep your first baseman is, I'd like to see a little bit of help there. I don't like my pitcher going that far.
Yeah, I would agree with that when he started chasing it.
Yeah.
He knows that's not his ball normally, but mm-hmm. I think he felt he had the best shot at it.
The 1-2 pitch misses, so 2-2 the count here. Garner stares in. Here comes the 2-2 offering. Sweeping pitch. Smith gets it on the corner. Call the strike.
Make a mistake, make up for it. Nice job there.
And that brings up the designated hitter, Peter Ward. Ward swung and missed his first at-bat. Singled, advanced on a balk, and became a run scored in the fourth. And now Garner reaches a little far outside for that one. 1-0 goes the count.
Unfortunately, the lefty's probably not going to get a lot of that outside corner because it's so far outside when it's coming in. That's
got to come
a
long way back.
Call.
The 1-0 pitch.
That
checks the belt. Called the strike.
One come of across the rare inside balls corner. That we've seen on the
across
inside,
the inside corner.
Corner. You got that right.
Yep.
An endangered species in today's game, to say the least.
Nice to see from that lefty being able to sweep right across the plate to the inside
the
corner.
1-1. Chopper back up the middle and into center field. Out of the reach of the diving shortstop, Nick Massa. Clean single for the designated hitter, Ward. And that brings up Peter Olgerholm, caught looking in his first at-bat, and then put out on a swinging bunt from the catcher to the first baseman, 2-3. And his next at-bat's 0-2 on the day is Olgerholm.
So look for the short ball here, especially with a runner on.
Garner staring right in at this one, delivers. This one popped up and out of play. Count goes to 0-1. 3-1, Nashoba's lead, top of the sixth inning here. One out, one on, an 0-1 count to Olgerholm at the plate. Garner leans all the way in. Now back set. The 0-1 pitch, sweeping to the outside corner, and Smith frames it in for a called strike.
And that's been a strike all day long on that outside corner. That river's pretty wide. I would say it's maybe the Missouri, maybe not the Rio Grande. I'd say the Mississippi or the Missouri.
And credit Smith, that catcher on the one knee with the long leg kicked out can get low and frame it back to the corner. The 0-2 offering, cut on and missed, and Olgerholm is retired.
Nice job by
but
Garner
it's been a strike
right
all night long for both sides, so.
Two strikeouts in the inning for Garner.
Pitcher
just the single given up.
Borsari.
And so that brings Borsari to the plate. Reached on an error twice, a run scored in the fourth. Reaches for this one. Chopped at the third baseman. Garcia up with it and on to first. 5-3 goes the put up, as goes the Chieftains. In the top of the sixth. They've got a 3-1 lead through 5.5. More to come. This is RFM.
Shrewsbury, 4 p.m. and Friday, home against Shepherd Hill, 4 p.m.
To the bottom of the sixth we go. Leominster chasing two. It's 3-1 Nashoba here on a Saturday night on Rivalry Family Media. The nightcap of a triple header of action here on Facebook today as James Borsari continues into the bottom of the sixth. And he goes back to the top of the Leominster order. 1-2-3 due up. Smith, Dutton, and McCarthy. And starts Smith off with a strike. Smith walked, got cut down in a fielder's choice, and then doubled and was a run scored in the fourth. Came to the plate in the fifth, and then the batting order pushed that away.
Ooh.
Little sweet chin music there. Misses up and in on the 0-2 pitch.
Once again, though, Borsari getting out in front of the batter quickly, starting him off. First pitch strike, second pitch strike. A little bit of chin music right there just to get him off the plate.
Nothing like it, you like better if you're a pitching coach.
Borsari with the 1-2, and Smith will line this one into the left field corner. Not going to get to that one. Around first and on his way to second goes Smith, and he will trot on into second with another stand-up double. Back-to-back stand-up doubles for Tyler Smith, and that, Bill Thomas, is why your catcher bats lead off.
Absolutely. Got to put the ball in play. Good things will happen, but he's found holes two at-bats in a row. Right center field and left field line turned them both into doubles.
The Nashoba baseball team coaching staff making a little bit of a defensive alignment adjustment on the left side of the infield and the outfield.
Smith straight away on the stand-up double, and now here comes Sean Dutton. Reached on a fielder's choice in his first at-bat, reached on an error, and got left at third in the fourth inning.
Borsari with another first pitch strike.
Yeah, kind of caught the batter a little bit off guard. You saw him kind of juke at the ball.
Mm-hmm.
And Dutton's going to ask for time to step out. Little cat and mouse going on there. Once again, he's got some room on that left-hand side. He's got some room on the right-hand side. That middle infield is pinching in hard on Smith.
Yeah. Third baseman off the line, but there is a beautiful
sweeping, breaking pitch on 0-1. Call the strike, 0-2.
Beautiful hole in that 6-5 hole on the left side of the infield.
Older home, by the way, has closed up that gap.
The 5.5 hole, I think, is what they call it.
Oger Holmes, 0-2 to Dutton. Oh. Called strike three.
Late break right there. Late break.
I don't like that.
He's had that pitch all night, though. You know, it's hard to complain. If the batters don't know that that's a strike by now,
you'll never know.
Yeah.
But having to lean that, as a right-handed batter, having to lean that far, the only thing you can do is foul it off.
Borsari hasn't come inside all night on anybody, though, except that one chin music. I'd be crowding the plate. I'd be talking about inching up. Maybe even moving up in the box a little bit, try to cut down the break on that breaking ball. You get it before it takes that hook. But, of course, it's hard to make mid-game adjustments on the fly like this, especially early in the season.
McCarthy couldn't hold back on that one, so in the hole 0-1. Now in the dirt. Bush doesn't know where it is, and the runner will advance 90 feet.
Can't find it.
And they still didn't know where it was, and Borsari had to come sprinting in and pick it up as Bush had no earthly idea where the ball was.
I lucked out there.
Too close to the plate, though, for Leominster to think about coming in. Could have been in a foot race from third and home, Smith moves up 90 feet.
Had they realized him, he really couldn't find, he never found it.
No, never did. Never did. Borsari had to come all the way in.
Heads up by Borsari to see that his catcher was in trouble there.
1-1 the count. McCarthy singled in his last at-bat, was caught looking the first time around. 1-1, waved at that one.
He's looking at the umpire on that one.
Again,
the Blue Devils
in the batters
have been silent, and it's not like that's the first time they've seen that pitch called a strike. Now it's been called a strike for everybody.
All night.
Everybody all night long, and he'll ask to think about it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 strikeouts for Borsari tonight. Here comes the 1-2 looking for 11, and that one misses away. Count levels at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
You say 10 strikeouts. We've had 16 outs, and he's had 10 of them by strikeouts here for setting down Blue Devils.
Yeah, defense has to work hard for Nashoba baseball team tonight.
The 2-2 cut on and missed. There's number 11.
Borsari not showing any signs of slowing down either. I know his pitch count's going to be up in the 70s by now, Kate, but he's definitely still dealing.
He certainly is, and very difficult when you've got back-to-back Ks in the heart of your order.
And that brings Nick Garcia to the plate, who looks at strike number one with two outs and a runner on 90 feet away from home. Garcia has been caught looking and waved at his first opportunity and looks at yet another breaking pitch.
Can't be choosy tonight.
I was going to say.
Everything's 0-2, 0-2, 0-2.
It's hard to work out of a hole. Deep into this one are the Blue Devils. The 0-2 pitch with two outs. Up and in for ball one.
Blue Devils need to find a way to scratch this run across.
Need the ball in play.
It would help.
Or a pass ball, something.
1-2 offering, and Bush tried to pull it.
That was in
that
the
one just a little
box.
Too far.
Oh, the right hand, left hand batter's box right there.
When you're cruising Bill Thomas, yeah, you try to find out how much.
How far you can get out there.
Here comes the 2-2. Oh, cut on and missed. And out of the inning with three straight strikeouts goes Borsari. Allows the double to open the top of the sixth and retires the side, looking, and swinging to end the inning.
And the boys lacrosse defeated
Littleton. A little figuring, but I got a question for you off air, so you have the answer when we come back.
All right, sounds like a plan. Through six complete here at Doyle Field. Leominster trails by two. It's Nashoba 3 and Leominster 1. More to come. This is RFM. Back to historic Doyle Field as we go to the seventh. Leominster in search of two, but they've got to get out of this inning clean, and Leominster's got a pitching change.
Get you a number in a second. It looks like
14. Tyler Godin, 14.
14.
And Godin will close the book on Garner. Garner in his inning and a third of work.
One and a third or two and a third, Todd?
He appeared in two innings, but he came in relief
after three and two-thirds.
Yeah, so two and a third. Thank you, Bill Thomas.
Finished the fourth, pitched the fifth and the sixth.
And Bill's doing that without any paperwork.
I know.
I'm doing this from memory. I love this baseball stuff, I'll tell you. I got nothing in front of me except
Bill Thomas will have the scorebook next game. I'll tell you that right now.
Oh, I'm dead. I'm dangerous with a scorebook. Trust me.
Oh, boy.
And that brings Godin to the plate.
It'll just give me
to the rubber,
to talk
excuse
about,
me.
That's all.
I'm all mashugana now. Here we go. All right, let's get settled down here.
My word.
8-9 top for Nashoba here in the seventh. So it's Morrison, Arsenault, and Ritchie due up in the inning, and the first delivery from Godin. Call the strike here in the seventh to Morrison. Morrison flew out in his first at-bat, drew a walk, and was cut down, 6-3 on a fielder's choice, and is next. Morrison will fly this one into the triangle, and making the catch over the shoulder style is Tony Savatelli. That was in that Bermuda Triangle, Bill Thomas,
no
in shallow right center.
Nice job staying with it. Only person that had a chance to get to it. Nice over the head grab, running with his back to the ball for the most part, but then turning, twisting, and making a great catch.
Indeed he did.
Just had the epiphany of how long it's going to take us to break all this stuff down.
Are you looking around?
I am. We got a lot of stuff.
Every time we set up, it's like we got an extra piece of equipment.
We got a lot tonight.
Yeah, well, we're experimenting.
That's right.
Oh,
and that one
right
from Godin
the,
slips.
The one
and
the one. Oh, come on,
that
kid.
One. Yeah, I was going to say, that one's a little bit carried away there. That was a pinch hitter in the inning,
that
by the
way. That almost
hit
the catcher right there. I mean, that was a little dangerous.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was Max Zoha.
Overreaction.
Who came into that one.
Really?
Overreaction.
I certainly don't like the thrown bat. I'll say that from a sporting standpoint. I do not like the thrown bat.
He's taking a minute.
It hurts. It hurts, and it's a cold night. No question about that. But
tough
you throw
crowd
a bat,
over here with the two
dangerous.
He's lucky. He's still on first base.
Yeah, I would agree.
As an umpire, a former umpire, I didn't tolerate that kind of stuff.
I will say, Bill Thomas, there is a great one from the Pro League, from the NPF. Call the second strike on a batter. Proceeds to stay at the plate. Homers, this thing is still in orbit on the 0-2 pitch.
Guess who the plate umpire
and
was.
The plate umpire was yours truly. The bat flip going to the dugout on her way. Oh, there's a thing of beauty.
It made the promo for the league the next year.
Oh, absolutely.
Throw him out of the game?
I was proud of her, quite frankly. I mean, it was beautiful. I didn't say a word.
She came up to you at least.
She should have thanked me for the assist on the home run, kept her at the plate. But
that was Wiggins, right? Wiggins?
Megan Wiggins, Georgia fame, and the USSSA pride. Beautiful bat flip. Might have showed the umpire up a little bit, but yeah, I probably deserve
take
it.
That.
We'll take it. Yeah. Comes the first delivery to Richie at the top of the order. That one called the strike. Zoha now hit by a pitch and finds himself at first base.
Bill Thomas in a fight. Megan Wiggins takes Todd just by blinking at him.
The 0-1 pitch.
Let me
called
guess.
The strike on the corner.
Was she a catcher or
so
center fielder? Great range.
Okay. No, she was fabulous.
Great range. Phenomenal hitter.
She could out hit
Georgia
anybody.
Played a lot of different positions, but Pro League played all the outfield spots. Here's the 0-2. Swing and a miss, and Richie retired on three straight pitches.
Been catching a little bit of the
and Dick Tucker pulls out. You're gonna love this. Dick Tucker pulls out the Yankee Stadium PC Richard advertisement there. I wonder if PC Richard is a sponsor over there. Is
he might be.
They contributing PC Richard, the Best Buy of Northern New Jersey. This one called the strike on the outside corner.
Might have a page in the Blue Devils program.
Y'all are crazy.
Do love this sport.
Downright diabolical.
0-1 the count to Klinkhammer. Godin with the pitch. This one lined into right field. Goes with the pitch. A unique thought. Misplayed out there in right field by Durkin. Up with it into the cutoff and able to advance. Was Zoha over to third.
Lucky to
back diving back in with the single as Klinkhammer. Big wide round over at first.
Solid single to
catcher number seven, Nolan Bush.
And that brings Nolan Bush to the plate. Bill Thomas, we've been saying it all night long. If that pitch is going to be good on the outside corner, you got to
go with it. You got to go with it. And that's what the Blue Devils have been unable to do tonight is drive that ball to right field. Got a mound visit here.
Yeah, Smith will head out to have a conversation with Tyler Godin, and Coach Vols will come out and have the conversation with him as well. 3-1 is the lead right now for Nashoba here in the top of the seventh.
You know, they're like an insurance run here, but it'll be interesting to see if Bossari comes out for the seventh inning. He's been dealing. He hasn't shown any signs of being tired. His pitch count's up in the 70s, I'm guessing, but I wouldn't be at all surprised if he doesn't
strikeouts.
Start. I wouldn't be at all surprised if he doesn't start the seventh inning, but maybe come out after if he allows a base runner. Let him go until he lets a base runner on.
He's allowed a couple of doubles to Tyler Smith. A handful of singles, three singles it looks like at this point, and the two doubles to Smith. Smith not due up in the next inning. Leominster in the middle of the order. It's Arsenal, Savatelli, and Martinez due up for Leominster. So that is 5-6-7 due up in the inning for Leominster coming up in the bottom half of the seventh inning. Not the ideal spot.
A statistician's reporting that Bossari's at 85 pitches, so he's at that, he's kind of that spot. Where does the coach want to put him out there for another 10 or 15? Where he's striking people out? We'll have to see.
Godin's first offering down low, dug out there by Smith, but it does allow the trailing runner Klinkhammer to advance 90 feet.
Nice stop.
Two runners in scoring position.
Smith keeping the ball in front of him there, that ball in the dirt. Stopped the run, and that run, that's a big run here with two outs. Big run sitting on third base there for Nashoba.
The 1-0 pitch coming up here from Godin. Sweeping breaking ball. Call the ball two.
Started out a little too high.
Two balls, no strikes, two outs, top of the seventh. Two on in scoring position for Nashoba. Pulls the string on that one. Does Godin pulls it a little too hard. 3-0 goes the count.
And here with a 3-0 with first base available, this may turn into a unintentional,
semi-intentional.
Yeah, the only logical choice.
Just don't groove one here because he's probably got the green light on
3-0. 3-0, high and outside, ball four.
I think that was a smart waste right there. Mm-hmm.
Loads the bases for your cleanup hitter for the Chieftains. Connor Salmon comes to the plate. Flew out to center field, walked in a run, scored in his second at bat, caught looking against Garner last inning.
You just don't want him to get good contact here. You want the ball on the ground. Interesting. Oh, well, we got two outs, so I'm like, why is the infield back? But two outs.
Yep.
Here comes Godin's first offering to Salmon. Called strike on the outside corner.
Salmon just looks like a kid that can drive.
Yes, he does.
The ball. He's just got that look.
He's got that impressive power hitter look.
Third baseman, prototypical third baseman up there just hacking away.
The 0-1 offering, line drive into center field. That will fall in and score one. Second one on the way to the plate. That scores as well. There's the insurance the Chieftains were looking for. And it's a two-run single here in the seventh for the cleanup hitter, Connor Salmon.
And fortuitous there with two outs. Obviously, we've got runners going on that hit.
Designated hitter number 14, Peter Ward.
Two runs on that. Just to the same place that he hit the last ball. The last time he flew out to the center fielder, that one he gets a nice line drive up the middle, scoring two, getting those insurance runs with two outs for the Nashoba baseball team.
5-1 goes Nashoba, is lead here in the top of the seventh, two outs. And Godin misses that one up and away. Peter Ward, the designated hitter at the plate. He's done his job as the designated hitter. Waved on the first opportunity at the plate. Single and a run score in the second at bat. Single and left on in the sixth. The 1-0. Ground ball gets by a diving Savatelli into right field. Up and around third. Trouble with it. Durkin out in right field. And around and scoring is Salmon from first base.
He was on second.
He had moved up.
Second baseman number 8, Peter Ogerholm.
Add another runner to that one.
Runner still on first and second here.
That was Bush who went around. That's why I had the number wrong. I just predicted a runner scoring, by the way.
You got to score him ahead of time. We got runners on first and second.
Hang on, there we go. Colored in the box.
You got a pencil.
It's like you're a rookie.
You need a pencil when you go in baseball.
Offering first pitch here outside.
Football. Bring me football. I can have Kate do stats. Billy does the analysis.
I describe
where the ball goes.
There's so many excuses right now.
See, I should be keeping the book, and you should be peeking at me.
Indeed. Ogerholm lines this one up and out of play.
We'll fix that next time.
I was going to say, we'll get this straightened out,
we'll
Bill Thomas.
That.
I don't know about you two.
Rivalry baseball comes your way next time, a couple of weeks from now, Wednesday night action right here. Could call it the Garner Bowl as head coach Chad Garner comes in with his against Leominster High School with his Fitchburg High School baseball team here to Doyle Field. We're looking forward to that one. We'll have it for you here on RFM Live, facebook.com/media rivalry for that one.
Interesting thing, tonight is one of the few games that Chad Garner would likely be able to see his son play in this season.
Yeah, given the 4 o'clock starts, 1-2 in Ogerholm, retired swinging will end the inning.
Nice two-out magic right there.
Three runs scored in the inning for the Chieftains. Push their lead to 6-1 through 6.5. More to come. This is RFM. Bottom of the seventh here at historic Doyle Field, up under the lights on a beautiful Saturday night here on Rivalry Family Media, and great to have you along with us. Todd Robbins, Bill Thomas, Kate Robbins, and you, thank you so much for being a part of our family, part of a triple header all day long. Leominster takes two from Littleton in La Crosse earlier today. That action a little further down the page. You'll want to check it out on replay. Opens up the bottom of the seventh, does Leominster with Arsenault, who singles straight up the middle.
Got to move around now. Can't waste any outs.
Yeah, they're chasing five here in the seventh.
Not going to do you any good to bunt the runner up here. Got to keep the line moving.
Middle of the order, 5, 6, 7 due up in the inning. Already know you're going to go a little farther. You'll see number 8 with the single opening up from Arsenault. Now Savatelli pops this one to right field, fisted toward the line. That one will fall in for a single.
Overrun by the right fielder.
And advancing on the play is Arsenault. He moved up on the single and was able to wrap it all the way around. As they had trouble fielding it out there, did Patrick Arsenault, playing too far off the line, Bill Thomas. Didn't expect him to go with it.
Yeah, you know, kind of surprised he wasn't playing a little more towards the line, but the first two batters reach here. Basari still on the mound, looking in the dugout. I think he's kind of surprised the coach hasn't come out to get him here. I thought maybe he'd get one base runner, but the coach has given him two, and he's...
Nico Martinez at the plate, hits a high fly ball into the Doyle Field night. Settled underneath it by Klinkhammer, who makes the catch in center field. Launches this one toward the plate, but that one was deep enough to score Arsenault from third, and Leominster's got their second run. Trading runs and outs, though, Bill Thomas, in this circumstance, not where you want to be.
No, no, not out, but I'm even surprised they threw the ball into home plate there. Runner on first base, a little bit heads-up running there over the cutoff, could be on second. Not that that run's all that important, but stay out of a force play.
It's a trade the Chieftains will make any time. Here's the ground ball from Durkin to the shortstop. Ricci up with it, on to second for one, over to first, not in time. Durkin reaches on the fielder's choice.
Get the lead runner.
Quick two outs there, though, after the two hits to start off the inning. You thought Leominster was really going to get into a rally, but Nashoba baseball team able to clean things up fairly
quickly.
Having
a phenomenal night.
Balsari's in position to finish off his own game right here.
Indeed he is. To the bottom of the order, it's Nick Massa. Sees a first pitch for a ball. The 1-0 offering. Catches the corner for a called strike on the inside, and there was that endangered species again, Kate. An inside pitch.
Tough curveball coming right at you, too.
Here comes the 1-1. Up and away. 2-1 goes the count. The 2-1 pitch. Down in the dirt.
Good hold there by the batter.
That's been the tease pitch all night.
Yep.
To 3-1. Can Massa lay off this one if Borsari misses? Runner at first is Durkin. The 3-1 offering.
Oh.
Stares it in for strike two.
I cannot look at that.
And, I mean, good things happened, Kate. Let's go back a few batters to Arsenault, yeah. Or check it, a few batters to Savatelli, who floated one into right field and got it to go. Just got to put the ball over there. Nobody's playing the line. The full count, runner going on the pitch. Called strike three, down the tube, inning and game over. 13 strikeouts for Borsari, and the last one with authority.
Leominster 2, next home game is coming up on Monday.
6-2, Nashoba, a winner at historic Doyle Field on a Saturday night. What action, great to have you with us. We'll recap it all for you in a couple of moments here. Nashoba, a winner by a 6-2. Two score, closing out our triple header. We'll have final word and final stats when we come back. This is High School Baseball on RFM. We continue on here on Facebook.com/Media Rivalry. We roll on for a little post-game show here from Doyle Field, recapping what has been a busy day. Triple header action to open the spring season here on RFM. Todd Robbins, Bill Thomas, Kate Robbins as well. Great to have you along with us. Nashoba, big win here tonight, Bill Thomas. A big six, make it, yeah, six, six runs two. Total. 6-2 in final. What a final. I mean, just the pitching performance for Borsari certainly will stand out in our mind, but you know, Leominster's Harris opened up having a great day. And then that fourth inning got a little squirrely, and then for Leominster, the wheels kind of fell off the bus.
Yeah, I think once they got Harris into the stretch, got him worrying about the base runners, he got off his game a little bit and bounced a couple of pitches. And before you know it, Nashoba had three runs up on the board. Leominster never found a way to solve Borsari's first pitch strikes. He was aggressive. He had full command of his fastball and his curve, and he mixed them up equally. When you keep the hitters guessing, and they're guessing wrong most of the time because both pitches are working equally well, you're going to have yourself a good night as a pitcher, and I think the stats are going to prove that out once you start talking about
the stat lines.
How solid Borsari really was, not just visually, but the numbers. Prove it.
It certainly does. Let's look at Borsari's line. Seven innings, a complete game effort. Six hits scattered across the field. Two runs, only one of those runs was earned. A single walk allowed in the game, Bill Thomas. It was the opening walk of the game. The opening batter, Tyler Smith, walked. The lone walk given up by Borsari in seven innings pitched. Here's the key number, 13 strikeouts on the night.
And at least one strikeout in every inning. He had three strikeout innings. And, you know, you expect the pitch count with that many strikeouts. You expect the pitch count to be over the top. But he had so many first and second pitch strikes that he was able to manage his pitch count with 13 strikeouts. That's kind of unheard of, that many strikeouts and still to be under 100 pitches. I mean, you expect a lot of those strikeouts to be four, five, six-pitch strikeouts. You know, you look at 13 strikeouts. If there's six-pitch strikeouts, that's 70 pitches and strikeouts right there, and it doesn't leave a lot of room for complete games when you're that effective in keeping the other team from putting the ball in play. But he was around the plate with every pitch. The umpire was appeared to be generous on more than one occasion, but I think the game was called fairly both ways. I just think that Borsari was dealing. He had better command, and he was able to utilize what the umpire was giving him. He took full advantage of the situation tonight, and it proves out in the stats.
Well, and he faced the minimum through three. Imagine that. Just nine batters faced.
That opening walk, catcher picked him off first base.
Indeed.
So, you know, that turned into a three-batter inning to start the game, and you know, I don't know how many innings. I know he had at least two innings where after letting the leadoff walk or even a leadoff hit or multiple base runners, come back and strike out the side after that. So he was in full control even when he did have base runners on. He didn't let he pitched out of the stretch, so he didn't have to worry about changing up.
And worked quick.
He was quick. He was, he didn't give Leominster the time to think about what was coming. And I think it helped him to get into a rhythm. But once again, I think Harris was bothered when he got put in the stretch after he put base runners on. Borsari pitched out of the stretch all night. He didn't care, and he's got a great move to first base, pitching out of the stretch all the time. He's very comfortable, it would appear, and he showed it tonight.
And Harris had a good night going through three innings as well.
Until
he hit the fourth inning, and then just the wheels kind of fell off in that fourth inning. But Harris's line as the starter will go over. 3 2/3 pitched, two hits. Two runs, none of them were earned due to errors in the field. Two walks, five strikeout performance for Harris of Leominster as the starter. Garner in relief, had a pretty good line going himself as he was able to come in, get himself a couple of strikeouts in that performance, stemmed the tide a little bit as didn't allow a run, and then Tyler Godin comes in the seventh, and things kind of go sideways for Leominster at that point in time, and really that's what leads to the lopsided 6-2 look. Otherwise, I mean, really, Bill Thomas, you were talking about a 4-2 game maybe in reality, you know, if you were to break things down, but hey, the runs that scored are the ones you count. 6-2 is the way it goes.
Yeah, and it's not like Leominster didn't have their opportunities, but Borsari just stepped up and shut him down. You know, I think at least one inning they had the first two batters on and then come back with some strikeouts and just, turn the switch off on the offense for Leominster. They just had no answer to his first pitch strike. And then he come right back with a second pitch strike. He didn't mess around. And then right with him, the number of three pitch strikeouts. And, you know, you show a lot of confidence and you got somewhere to go. And he's getting there on time tonight.
And he just poured him on throughout the day today. Great effort for James Borsari. Hit as well. Of course, I mean, you want to talk about everything coming up roses for you, you know, Bill
scored
Thomas.
A couple of runs.
He scored a run. He reached his first two at bats. He reached on errors.
Well, he got
on
base. Put the ball in play.
He reached on errors, put the ball in play, but reached on errors. Run scored and then was retired. He grounded out to conclude the sixth inning. That was like the only negative I can give you on Borsari's card today. He grounded out to end the sixth inning. That was about it as far as negatives go. Other than that, everything came up Borsari today inside of Doyle Field.
Is that code for roses?
Indeed.
For Borsari.
Indeed, it is. Chieftains, Nashoba baseball team gets their first win. Oh, Bill Thomas. I just got red-skinned. Look out. My goodness. This, of course, Chieftains has been retired for Nashoba Regional. They will be the Wolves coming up. That's currently in beta at this moment in time. For the moment,
Gawkwin's done the same thing.
They're Nashoba baseball team, and so we'll get to that point. But I was hoping for a clean card tonight. I tripped up on it there, much the same way the folks at Fox, of course, call the NFC action on the football side. Yep. Slipped a couple of Redskins in there for the Washington Football Club this year. I had a couple of slip-ups there tonight. So, Tanya Rich, I'm sorry, one slap there for me for that one, but we're getting close. We're making it work, nonetheless, and for the right reasons, to say the least. So Nashoba and their baseball team goes to 1-0.
The fact that we had a chance to use the name that's not the preferred name.
Yes.
Is still a good thing because it means we're out here playing games.
That's correct. Which
and
is
we
a step
have
in
the opportunity
right
to make those mistakes.
And we'll work our way to the other solution later. I'm excited about Wolves. I'm looking forward to see the new logo.
I am too. We'll
as
see how
well.
It plays should out. Be a, it should make a nice logo. Maybe a,
absolutely.
An aggressive looking wolf head.
You know something? Yeah, absolutely.
Something. Yeah, absolutely.
Leominster Falls
Howling
to
at the moon, maybe.
Well, that's right. Leominster Falls to 1-1. With the loss tonight. So they've kind of seen the best of both worlds, had an offensive explosion, win 7-0 against Wachusett. Tonight, offense didn't really show, and defensively maybe you got stopped by a hot pitcher, and so you find yourself in a situation where you're 1-1 through the first two games of the season. But Bill Thomas, this is a short, compact spring season. You're going to play 10, 12 games in a real tight window, then into like a conference baseball tournament, and then into a state playoff. That's what you're going to see coming up here in short succession here over the next so many weeks. The game will turn our attention to far ahead on their schedule a couple weeks from now. It's May the 19th. It's a Wednesday night. It's right here at historic Doyle Field. It's Rivalry Baseball, Leominster and Fitchburg coming up here, 7 o'clock first pitch, under the lights here at Doyle Field. How better would you ask for the two rivals to get together with Leominster and Fitchburg? That's coming up on May the 19th. It'll be the next baseball action we have for you here on RFM. And again, we call it maybe the little mini Garner Bowl there. You've got, of course, Chad Garner, new head baseball coach at Fitchburg, as he works for the Fitchburg Public Schools, his son Ryan Gardner, you saw pitching tonight, and Ryan has been Leominster through and through, grew up here, has played through the youth baseball system here. Coach Garner coached him through here, and now they kind of on opposite ends. I had the opportunity to ask Coach Garner about this just before he got the job officially. You know, if I said, you know, what if you know, and he said, absolutely not. Ryan wants to be a Leominster baseball player, is excited to be a Leominster baseball player, and I will be there to support him. Maybe not wearing blue and white when I do it, but I will be there to support him. So certainly.
Well, he wasn't wearing red tonight either.
He was not. No, he wore the neutrals.
He was neutral.
Yeah, the neutrals.
I agree.
You will see a lot of neutrals.
I give Chad a lot of credit. But, yeah, his allegiance are a little torn now with his new assignment as the head baseball coach over at Fitchburg. And his son, performing well here with the Leominster Varsity baseball team. So it was nice to see Chad here tonight.
Indeed it was. And as Kate pointed out, maybe only one of the few opportunities he will get.
We will see him in 2 weeks, but he'll be in a different capacity.
He'll be in a different capacity. Which
he'll
will
have
be.
His game face on.
Indeed.
And when he has his game face on, stay away. That's all I can say. Because he's a pretty intense person.
He's an intense guy, to say the least.
But he's a fun guy, too.
So many ways to watch this one. Of course, live action here on RFM. Facebook.com/MediaRivalry. Game available same day on demand. This baseball game may take a little longer. We got a little copyright with the music between innings we got to work out. So look for this one tomorrow on YouTube, but it will be there in a 24-hour turnaround. YouTube.com. Search Rivalry Family Media. Like, follow, and subscribe today. When we go live, your smart enabled device gets the notification and you're able to tune in or follow that tiny URL directly out to YouTube. Schedule updates and reports from all across the region. We bring all those resources together out there on Twitter at Media Rivalry for that action as well. Happy to have you with us tonight. Great day. Closing out a triple header of action. Been a busy, busy day here at Doyle Field. But the spring season is in full swing, and hope certainly sprung eternal as we look across the day today. Go all the way back to that first game of action. Littleton and Leominster girls lacrosse. Leominster a 15-7 win in that one to open the day. Boys lacrosse comes back in the second game, picks up a win over Littleton as well in an exciting matchup. And then Leominster baseball drops the night game of the triple header, 6-2 the final in that one. The Nashoba baseball team picks up the win and picks up their first win of this season in their first game as well. Leominster falls 2-1-1. We thank you so very much for being a part of our family over the last 7 hours or so here on Facebook. Lots of ways to be a part of it. We're back with you for lacrosse action coming up on Thursday night here on RFM. Marlboro is the opponent for Leominster next week in lacrosse action. Thursday, the 13th of May, it's Marlboro and Leominster boys lacrosse. 5:30 is the first face-off of that one, and we will have that action for you at 5:20 here on Facebook. Followed up on Saturday, girls lacrosse action as they play Marlboro, and 11 a.m. first draw on that action. We'll be with you at 10 minutes to the top of that hour as well next week. We thank you so very much for joining us once again. Nashoba winner, 6-2 over Leominster tonight. For Bill Thomas and Kate Robbins, I am Todd Robbins saying thank you so very much for joining us. And until next Thursday night on the lacrosse end of things, so long, everybody.